It was a regular Saturday morning when I felt a dull ache creeping up my lower back. 2 days ago, I was in a 2-day training where mostly I was sitting. But as the hours passed, the pain became unbearable, shooting up my spine like balls of electricity. By evening, I could barely move. The discomfort has transformed far more serious. Every step, like a struggle, as if my back were being crushed under an invisible weight. Before I knew it, I was being rushed to the emergency room due to an agony. This exigency compelled my husband to bring me to Cardinal Santos. I thought something had gone terribly wrong with my back, maybe a slip disc. But after a series of questions from my doctor and a stomach X-ray, I was shocked by the diagnosis. Severe constipation? Yes, the intense back pain wasn't due to an injury, but from the buildup of pressure that had spiraled out of control. As embarrassing as it sounded, I learned a valuable lesson that day about taking my body's signals seriously. Ignoring what seemed like a minor issue landed me in the ER, and the doctor's solution? A simple lifestyle change, including more fiber and water. So, don't wait until you're in the emergency room for something preventable like I did. Your body deserves better care. So tonight, I will be sharing some self-care habits. Hopefully, you would consider and embrace your lifestyle change. Self-care to many seemed selfish. But to me, self-care is all about personal responsibility. Because fill your own cup. Because you cannot pour from an empty cup, right? Can I see a thumbs up if you agree on this? Yes, thank you. So, for us to have self-care, we need to have a good night's rest or a good sleep. So it happens in the evening. Take a hot bath, no phones 1 hour before bedtime, writing your gratitude journal to have that positivity, and 5 minutes meditation before sleeping, and as much as possible, sleep early, 10 p.m., lights off, so that you'll be able to wake up at 4 a.m. or 5 a.m., do your 20-minute meditation and prayer, 20-minute workout, and 20-minute learning. And write your top three goals for the day. Let me share to you my journey. For the past, how many days? 90 days. Okay. Have you seen the video? So I started with this one. Right? I weighed 74 kilograms. Now, here's me. So, can you see the difference? Very small, but I feel lighter. I feel more energetic, and I love my body. I get to appreciate my body more. Another thing that I have changed in my lifestyle is the food that I eat. I am doing intermittent fasting. So meaning 16 hours of fasting and 8 hours of eating. I start eating during lunchtime and end it by 8 p.m. So I cannot eat anymore after this meeting. I drink barley in the morning for cleansing, and I make sure that I have 8 glasses of water all throughout the day to stay hydrated. And eat more fiber as my doctor recommended. And this probably is something new to everyone that I try my best to practice every day. It's clearing. More than what we feed our body and what we do to our body is I feel also the emotional baggages that we carry every single day. So as much as possible, I try to get out of all the blaming, the anger, the guilt, the shame inside of me. Being more compassionate about myself, taking care of my emotional well-being, and saying no to excuses because that is part of self-care. As in Frozen, let it go, let it go. And lastly, we cannot demand affirmation from other people, we can only demand it from ourselves. For myself, by saying these three magic words, encouraging everyone to say it with me. I am capable. Can you all unmute and say, I am capable?
I am
I am
I am
capable.
capable.
I am
I
capable. Thank you. I am responsible.
am
I am
responsible.
responsible.
I am responsible.
Thank you. And I matter.
I matter.
I
I
matter.
matter.
Fellow Toastmasters, self-care is our own personal responsibility. If you found value in what I have shared, I'm encouraging you to listen more from me. I do have a podcast called Unlocking Miracles. I share their tips and tricks about life, about best practices, lifestyle, having an abundance mindset. So let's make sure that we are taking care of ourselves because we only have one life to live. Back to you, Toastmaster Emma.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Janice. That's I am capable, I am responsible, and I matter. Thank you for all those self-care tips, and I hope we learn from your speech and we become all healthy and wealthy. Okay, so we've come to, are we going to have a break, maybe a picture taking for